हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम यू ऑल टू टुडे सेशन फ्रॉम श्री बसवा पब्लिक स्कूल इलकर। चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द चैप्टर 3 एंड दैट इज ट्रीज। सो बिफोर वी बिगिन आवर डिस्कशन, लेट्स नो सम फैक्ट्स अबाउट ट्रीज। लेट्स सी द फैक्ट्स अबाउट ट्रीज एंड दैट इज ट्रीज आर द बिगेस्ट प्लांट्स ऑन दिस अर्थ। Trees are the biggest plants on this earth. Our plants are classified into 5 types, that is trees, herbs, shrubs, climbers, creepers. Among these all, trees are the largest and biggest plants on this earth. Trees have very thick stem known as trunk. What we call for the tree's stem? Trunk. Trees prepare their own food. All plants prepare their own food. With this, let's begin the chapter trees. Trees belongs to many different families, many different groups, but all they have thick woody stem. The wood supports the trees to allow them to grow taller and also larger than any other plants on this earth. With the help of wood, they are grow taller and also wider. Trees provide us one of the useful and important material on this earth, and that is wood. It provide us wood, which is very useful for all of us. The trunk of the tree is covered with bark. What we call for this? Bark. The bark will protect the trees from any harsh weather conditions, means changing weather conditions, and also being eaten by any other animals. So it protects from the harsh weather conditions and also from any other animals. The trees that present around us are right, pine, coconut tree, fir tree, banyan tree, and mango tree. So these are all the trees that present around us. Children, have you ever seen forest floor or any forest? So if I ask you anything about the forest, the first thing that comes in your mind is that the forest include large number of tall trees. Is it? They are grown naturally. So there are forests in every state of India. Each forest has tree which is suited to the soil and the climate of that particular place. So if you observe the forest floor, you will see some leaves fallen from the trees, and those leaves will help the land to what? Get away from the sun rays, so that the leaf litter feeds whole forest and also protect the land from the direct sunlight. Okay, now let's see the kinds of trees, the types of trees. Trees are broadly divided into two types, and that is first one, evergreen trees, and deciduous trees. So let's see one by one. And the first one is evergreen trees. These evergreen trees can also be classified into two groups by the shape of the leaves they produce and also the way they make the seeds. They are also classified into according to the shape of the leaf and also the way they produce the seeds in them. The trees with wide flat leaves that make seeds in flower are known as what? Broad-leaved trees. What we call broad-leaved trees. These trees have wide leaves, flat leaves, and also they make seeds in flowers. And these trees have leaves on them throughout the year. Their branches never become bare, means the leaves will not fall altogether from the trees. So evergreen trees are always green or throughout the year. The leaves are green throughout the year. Hence, these kinds of trees are known as evergreen trees. They shed their leaves, but the new leaves will be grown soon on that place. The dead one will be replaced soon by the new leaf. A evergreen trees drop leaves in once or two times in throughout the year. They too drop the leaves, but one by one, not all together. They will drop in a year once or two times. Okay, so these are all the fact about the evergreen trees. Some evergreen trees that grows in a plain surface are tamarind, mango tree, rosewood, and mahogany. These all trees are very tall and with the thick branches which grow from the main trunk. They grow from the main trunk. They are very thick branches and very tall too. Some evergreen trees that grow in a mountains too. Some of them will grow in a mountains too. Evergreen forest have trees like pine, fir, then cedar and cypress. These are all the trees which will grow on the mountains, and these all called as evergreen tree. What we call evergreen trees. Such kinds of trees are found in especially Himachal Pradesh, northern parts of Uttarakhand, northern West Bengal, Sikkim and Kashmir too. These kinds of trees do not produce any flowers. They don't produce any flowers. So they make seeds in cones. How they produce? In a form of cones. So such kinds of trees are called as conifers or coniferous trees. What we call conifers or coniferous trees. These trees grow tall and straight with narrow branches. They have very narrow branches. They do have a small but long, narrow, needle-like leaves. They have shape like a needle leaves. They have sloping branches. They have in a shape of slope. The shape of the tree and its branches are suited for the cold climate. They are very suitable for the cold climate. In winter, when it snows, the snow just slide on from the branches so that the branches do not break under the weight of heavy snow. So this is the benefit of having sloping branches. Alright children, now let's see the other kind of tree, and that is deciduous trees. These trees shed their leaves during specific part of the year. They shed their leaves during a specific part of the year. And also depending upon the place where they grow. At that particular time of the year, their branches become bare. At the particular time, all leaves will be fallen from the tree. So it becomes bare. These trees lost their all leaves at once, mostly in autumn season. In which season all they drop the leaves? Mostly in the autumn season. Getting rid of the leaves help to stop the trees from drying up when the soil is frozen or very dry. Then the trees then again rest for the whole winter. Means no leaves will produce on the trees during whole winter. Some deciduous trees which grow in plain surface. For example, sal tree, teak tree and shesham tree. These trees are the deciduous tree which grow on a plain surface. These trees are found in forest of Madhya Pradesh, Bihar and Uttar Pradesh. Generally, these trees shed their leaves just before the hot dry summer month. Means before the hot dry summer month, these deciduous trees will change the leaf color before the summer month, and new leaves will be grown during monsoon season. So in the rainy season, new leaves will be grown. The deciduous trees that grow in a cold climate, they shed their leaves just before the winter season. Means before the winter season, the trees that will grow in a cold climate, they shed before the winter season. Then the new leaves will be appear in a spring season during during spring season, the new leaves will be appear. Example for such kinds of trees are willow, chinar, and poplar, which grow in Kashmir. Besides these trees, deciduous and evergreen trees, in a forest like dry forest in a Gujarat state, other trees also grown. Like for example, mostly the bubble trees grows well. In the dry forest of Gujarat, we will get bubble trees. The coastal areas means near any sea or ocean side, the palm trees grow well. The coconut palm grows well. And also areca palm, even oil palm, etc. grows well any near coastal areas. These trees are not found in natural forest. They are grown at the coastal areas. They have to be planted by the man. Someone has to be plant, then they will grow. They will not found naturally. So near coastal areas, we will have large plantation of these palm. Okay. All right, children. Now, today we will stop here, and in the next session we shall continue the remaining part. And this is your today's homework. Solve it in your EVS textbook and copy the same thing in your EVS homework book.